to raise your perspectives, your opinions about something. Only that, just to raise, to state your opinions. That means to argue.
To argue is also to prove your opinion is right.
Okay.
You try to prove it.
Okay. Not only to state your opinions, to prove the truth of your opinions, to persuade the other to believe in your opinion, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Quang Minh. So to argue here is a very popular verb used in different language, but it has a little bit kind of light difference between languages. If it comes from French roots, to argue means to make clear something, to assert something, to prove something. But it does also mean to accuse or to convict someone of something, right? And therefore, you see, it has two meanings. In Latin root, that means to bite, to rattle, okay? It's stronger, not only to make something clear, but it seems to present the opposing opinion to someone. That means to rattle in Latin root. You see, light differences. But the central meaning here is also to make clear and to persuade the other. In English root, to argue means to bring reasons to support or deny an idea, a view, or proposition. So therefore, if you want to argue with someone, the most important thing is that you have to make clear by bringing reasons. Or to argue also means to maintain that something is the case. Not a proposition, but the case based on the previous proposition. However, in both cases, you have to bring reasons to prove your ideas, right? Therefore, you see, Quang Minh, to argue is not simply to state opinions, but also to prove opinion by bringing reasons to support your ideas. That's it. Now, we go further. So what about argument? That is a verb. Now we turn out to be a noun. So argument is a series of statements. Some statements is just a proposition, and therefore you shouldn't back it by evidence. So you hear some equip or back or proof with evidence, but the other statement is just opinions or views, and therefore it's maybe logically linked with the previous evidence. Therefore, it is not need to be backed by evidence. And these series of statements are presented purposely. Purposely including how to organize it, how to connect it together. So with a purpose to prove or disprove a given position. That is an argument, okay? So now, arguments often consist of two statements, okay? One is claimed to be a reason and another is a conclusion. You have to give reasons for your conclusion. Reason is the way you prove your ideas. And therefore, because arguments must include reasons, and the key central part of arguments is reasoning. And therefore, the term argument is often also referred to as a set of reasons or a reason for a particular statement. That is the meaning of arguments. So now the main issues, we just have the concept about argument, but it is not difficult. The most difficult thing is that how to prove, how to argue that something is true or something is untrue. How? For example, I could like you to prove that Thảo Linh is a very good secretary of our youth, the Communist Party, right? Đoàn thanh niên là gì các em? Tự nhiên lâu quá cũng không nhớ cái từ đó nữa.
Youth community cô.
Youth community. Điều đó có phải là đoàn thanh niên không? Hay là hội liên hiệp youth association is different, right? Okay. So now, Thảo Linh is secretary of your class, youth community. And I would like you to prove that she is an excellent secretary of the youth community. How do you prove it? How do you persuade, give reasons to this statement? Or we just say, Thảo Linh is a good leader. That'd be easier for you, broader for you to prove. Okay? It's just an example. Maybe it's not true. I don't know, right? Just think of the way to prove that statement. Where should you start in order to persuade the other? Quỳnh Nhi, let me just throw away the tea bag. Okay, Whitney.
Yes.
I would like you to prove a statement that someone, okay, Miss A is a good leader. So how can you prove that? You would like to prove that statement. How do you prove it? Or even you would like to disprove that statement. How do you do it? How can you argue?
Could you wait for me for a minute? My phone is have the low battery.
Okay. Okay, the others. Where am I? Have I any idea?
Yes. So to prove that Thảo Linh is a good leader, I will based on the fact, the activities or there's, the result of the copyright process. She worked with me and my group. Yes,
and then you come
and can I come to a conclusion that she a good leader if the results the results of working with her is good or something like that.
Okay, you started from her past operations, right? Leadership in the past. And you focus on particular cases. For example, your class have to organize a tour, right? Practical tour for something. So she's very actively lead the class and order cases for example, some of the moot courts, and then she actively lead the class to be successful in that competition, etc. So you started from different cases. And then you come to the conclusion. So what kind of argument is it? Deductive or inductive? Cái loại chứng minh kiểu đó, khi các em bắt đầu từ những cái vụ việc nhỏ, những cái tình huống, rồi từ đó các em dẫn đến kết luận, thì cái kiểu cách chứng minh đó là gì? Quy nạp hay diễn dịch? Quy nạp inductive, diễn dịch deductive. Cách chứng minh đó là inductive or deductive. Where am I?
I think that inductive.
Inductive, right? Because we start from minor premises that, hey, minor cases, and all of us, then you have to persuade those results are true. And consider one of the criteria for evaluating the leaderships, and then you come to the conclusion. That is kind of inductive. Another way, how can you prove with the deductive way? Another person, not Hue Mai anymore. I need someone else. Now, I would like you to use the technique of deductive in order to prove that Miss A is a good leader. She has a very good leadership. Thanh Nhàn.
Yes, teacher. First of all, I will give the conclusion. Miss A is a good leader, and after that, I will give.
That is not a conclusion. That is a statement that you have to prove.
Yes, the statement. And after that, we'll give some supporting ideas like. About her activity in the past, and
that may be the same as Hue Mai mentions previously. Is it? You started from particular activity of Miss A in the past, and then you come to the conclusion. Is it? So that is the same way. It is just the inductive. Now I would like you to use another way to prove things. Use deductive way. Okay, right. Okay. When I noted to me that we just finished reading text about law. We didn't finish text. Reading text of the law. No worry. If we have much more time, I will return to that part later on. Now we'll focus on arguments. Thanh Nhàn, don't you know how to prove it? Don't you think of another way to prove that statement?
Sorry, miss.
No, okay. What about the others? Can anyone think of something, Hi Long? Hi Long.
Yeah, I'm here, miss.
Can you address my question?
Okay, so
If I have to prove Helen is a good leader in a deductive way, I would say that she possesses an amazing leader skills, because the first reason is that she always hear the members of opinions carefully and honestly. Besides, she also cares for our feelings and always tries her best to complete the work and forces us to complete works on time. Yes, I think so.
Okay. So I think that you are not very much familiar with the deductive way, right? So differently from the previous inductive way that we start with particular cases, particular results in the past of Miss A in her leadership in order to come to the matching of these kind of cases with particular criteria for good leadership. And then we come to the conclusion. You see, particular cases that match the criteria. We need to have criteria. How is we consider good leadership, the definitions of good leadership, the concept of good leadership, and the criteria for defining which leadership is good and which leadership is bad. Okay, so particular cases that help us to match her capacity with particular criteria of good leadership, and then we come to the conclusion. But now in terms of deductive way, we should start with criteria for good leadership. We have to start from that. If you agree with me, one of the criteria for good leadership is to make all of the all of the members of the class or that of that group to be involved in the teamwork. Okay, so that is the way that to involve, to persuade, to promote every member to participate actively in the teamwork, and how to lead the teamwork effectively to bring the results. If you agree with us, that criteria, and then we start from that general rule, general criteria, and then we agree. Then I will prove that Miss Ling has matched with that big criteria. So particular cases, I lead you to those particular cases, and then I come to the conclusion. Can you see the map of that argument? Because we are not in the classroom, so I suppose that you might be a little bit different here. We have inductive way. How can I do it? So I start from particular case, right? Or example. I start with from that. And then what else? From these, I come to the criteria that all of these things match all of these things, match with criteria one of good leadership. Okay. for example, that persuade or promote the participation of every, it means all and each. Okay, so you see, for the first criteria, Miss A is good leadership. And then you come to the second criteria of leaderships, good leaderships, because good leaderships requires a lot of criterias. For example, 5 criterias. Similarly, you do for the criteria 2, criteria 3, and then you come to the conclusion, right? That is the way you prove things. But that is not the only way. We have another way. That means the deductive way. How can deductive way work, the mechanism? So now I come to deductive way. So I don't start with particular examples, but I should start with the definitions of good leaderships. Okay. And then I have to prove that good leaderships require okay, I have to hear a call because it's come from King of ONA. Yeah. There. Okay, I'm so sorry for when an emergency call that we have to decide something in terms of the work of the university, right? So therefore here, if you start with the general statements that good leadership must meet five criteria and all of us must agree on this general statement, we agree, right? That is the scientific knowledge and that is a popular acceptance. And including these five criteria, we start with the criteria one, because it is accepted widely that we don't argue on the minor premise here, the truth. And then I come to particular example in terms of Miss A cases, Miss A case, and then these kind of examples proof for the general statements here, and that is the way that I prove the conclusion is true, right? She meets criteria 1, 2, 3, 5, and then she is a good leader. That is two ways of proving things, you know, arguments. So therefore now, types of arguments, there are two types. Deductive arguments and inductive arguments. Deductive arguments normally starts with a very general proposition and ends with a particular or ends with a general proposition. There are two ways of using deductive arguments. First, general to general reasoning. Proving things. The second one is general to particular reasoning. The second one is called categorical syllogism. I wonder whether you studied logic. Lớp các em có học môn logic không? Yes or no?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so it's good because you have some background in terms of logic. Logic way of proving things. So it's not strange. It's very familiar to you. Now I give you a general example first, and then we come to the legal arguments later, okay? And the first one, reasoning by deductive way, but starts with general and come to the conclusion of general. This is not used in legal context, okay? Not used in legal context. For example here, all mammals are warm-blooded. That is a truth, right? And now premise two, all dogs are mammals. And therefore we come to the conclusion all dogs are warm-blooded. This way of proving is not used in legal reasoning. Why? Because it's too broad. Often we would like to deal with a particular case, but rather than come to a from general issues to another general one, and it is not very solid ways of proving things. And therefore it's not used in legal context. Now I come to the second type of deductive reasoning, which starts with a general proposition but ends with a particular one. And this is a model. All mammals are warm-blooded. Dog feeder is a mammal, and therefore dog feeder is warm-blooded. Okay, so you see, this is the truth. Okay, and then it is widely accepted as a knowledge, a true knowledge, justice. And then we would like to prove the second one, duck video is memo, but it is also widely accepted. Okay, and then this is also the truth, and therefore we can come to a very sound conclusion. Sound, effective, valid argument. A sound argument is a valid one, okay? Is an effective one. Now, legal context. The same models, but it's used in our legal arguments. Major premise. All human beings have the right to life. Mr. John Nelson is a human being. Mr. John Nelson has the right to life. Is it the true conclusion? Do you think this is true conclusion or not? Who agree this is a good argument? Raise your hand. Who agree this is the true and the good arguments? Raise your hand. Okay. Okay, keep your hands raised, okay? Now there are some persons. Thảo V, Ngọc Thảo. Okay, Thảo V and Thu Thủy didn't raise her hands. So I would like to know her comments on this argument. Why in her opinions, this argument is not good, not valid. Thảo Vy, keep raise your hands, okay? Because I would like to know who didn't raise hand and why. So here I have Thu Thảo and and Ngọc Vy and Thu Thủy. Okay, Ngọc Vy, go ahead. Can you state your opinions and try to argue with the balance of your class to the others regarding your points of view? So here, because Nopi is not in the classroom, so I would like to make a minor for Nopi. Nopi is not here. Thu Thủy, the same, right? Okay, lower your hands. Ngọc Vy and Thu Thủy each has one minus. Okay, now lower your hands. And I could like you to give me an example of yourself. Try to imitate, copy this model. And try to give your own example. Vũ Hà Trang, lower your hand, good. So now type your examples into the chat box. I'm waiting for your example, your own example. Thu Thủy, what happened, Thu Thủy? Thu Thủy now raised hand. Okay, lower your hands already. Now give your example into chat box. Using the examples that I have already gave you, the model here. General to particular, okay? So this is the way that you prove things, to persuade the others of your, about your statements. here I have some example from Huỳnh Nga. Okay. Everyone must type your example into Thảo Vy, where were you? Because previously I called your name, but you were not there.
Yes, sorry, it's not me. She's Ngọc Thảo Vy. My name is Nguyễn Thị Thảo Vy.
Okay. Thảo Vy and Ngọc Vy. Her name is Ngọc Vy, is it?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Sorry for that mistake. Thành Linh. Okay. Okay. Right. So now I could like you to review certain example here. Okay, so we have several examples here. What is an example here? Whether it's correct or not? Okay, so enough example. Okay, thank you. Now we have to review all of these examples carefully in order to, okay, PV, Thảo Vy, Ngọc Vy, a lot of V in your class. So I have to be careful. If not, I will make a mistake. Okay, so now we have to focus on this example and give our analysis regarding these arguments. The first one, every road user must comply with the traffic law. Mr. A is driving in his PR morning. And therefore, okay. Mr. A must comply with the traffic law. Is there any problem with this argument? Is it the proper structure of deductive arguments, general to particular? Is it a proper argument or not? Something wrong here. Do you recognize it? Do you recognize some mistakes here? For the first argument, have some problem. Can you recognize what's wrong here? Lớp có thấy cái gì sai trong cái cấu trúc mà sử dụng cái deductive argument trong cái câu 1 này không? Again, can you see some mistakes taken here?
In the first sentence, she mentioned about the role, but in the second, she just mentioned like the not the road, so I think it's not equivalent.
Okay, look at the general statements. Okay, in the general statements, the subject is the road user. The requirements in with respect to road user must is that road user must comply with the traffic law. So if you would like to come to the conclusion that Mr. A must comply with the traffic law, what about minor premise? Is there any matching between general minutes, premise, general statements, with minor statements here? There's matching or not? Look at the example again here. All humans beings, okay? All humans beings, all people, all persons have the right to life. Mr. John Nelson is a human being because he's belonging to this subject. And then, therefore, Mr. John Nelson has the right to life. That is the sample, the way we prove things. There is complete matching between minor premise and major premise. And therefore, with that matching, we come to the conclusion. Without matching between minor and major premise, you cannot come to such a conclusion. Kwati, you have recognized a mistake of this argument, is it?
Yeah. If we have the major and the minor premise, the minor premise is Mr. A is a road user.
Yeah, minor premise has a problem because it's not matching with the major premise. The major premise have two elements. Who? Road user. What to do? What is the task? Comply with the traffic law. So the general statements has two elements, two components, right? Who and their obligations. But the minor one you would like to lead to a particular case, that is the case of Mr. A. But what happened to Mr. A is driving his PR morning. Elements that you mentioned with Mr. A is that he is driving his PR morning. It is not matching with the elements of the general statements. Okay, it's not matching anything without matching. And therefore, it is very illogic when you connect with the conclusion and then Mr. A must comply with the traffic law. Bạn thấy vấn đề của mình chưa? Ví dụ một này nè, thấy vấn đề của mình chưa?
Dạ rồi ạ. So I can fix it by writing this way. Mr. A is a road user as he is driving in his Kia morning. Could that be possible?
Yes, but it's unnecessary, the second part. Mr. A is a road user is enough.
Okay.
Because within the general statements, you didn't list out all of the details. Who is road user? Okay.
Nếu mà các em đi vào chi tiết nè, Huỳnh Nga fix up cái câu của mình á, Huỳnh Nga thấy rằng là trong câu chính của chúng ta có hai yếu tố thôi. Thứ nhất là ai, đúng không? Là những người tham gia giao thông đường bộ. Phải làm gì thì là phải tuân thủ luật giao thông. Đúng giờ cái general statement em có hai cái ý đó thôi. Thế thì ở trong cái câu này, vì general, từ cái general này chúng ta vào một cái particular case là của Mr. A. và chúng ta muốn chứng minh rằng Mr. A, cái conclusion của em này, em
Cô chưa mở mic à?
Okay, right. I'm sorry for internet connections problem. I just was kicked out. I think that there are some problem with the caps over the sea, right? There is still problem. Rồi, như vậy em fix up thì em chỉ cần nói là Mr. A is a road user. Okay, and then come to the conclusion. Còn cái activities particularly in order to prove road user, you have to prove or to list out criteria who are road user. For example, you have to come to the second deductive arguments. Road users are those who involved in road traffic by, for example, walking, driving vehicles. Đúng không? Cái thứ hai nữa, nếu mà em muốn dài ra cái câu như hồi nãy á, Huỳnh Nga là Huỳnh Nga muốn sửa câu này là ông A là một road user, bởi vì là as he's driving his Kia Morning thì cái phần đằng sau á là vì ông ta lái chiếc xe Kia Morning á, nó thừa ở trong cái cấu trúc này của chúng ta. Và nếu các em muốn cái điều đó thì các em lại phải lập một cái cấu trúc chứng minh mới nữa, một cái deductive mới nữa, là các em phải chứng minh là road user là những người tham gia vào giao thông đường bộ, bao gồm người đi bộ hoặc người lái các phương tiện tham gia giao thông. Đó, thì các em lại có một cái general premise tiếp theo. Rồi các em lại chứng minh một cái minor premise là ông A lái chiếc Kia Morning. Như vậy là trong cái câu general chúng ta nói rằng những người road user là những người đi bộ hoặc lái phương tiện tham gia vào giao thông. Thế thì chúng ta mới nói là ông ta lái cái Kia Morning và ông ta đang tham gia vào giao thông. Đúng chưa? Thì chúng ta mới match với cái general again. Như vậy là các em phải có dùng nhiều lần cái deductive arguments. Còn một lần thì các em chỉ dùng là every road user must comply with the traffic law. Mr. A is a road user. Therefore, Mr. A must comply with the traffic law. It's enough. Okay? The next one also has a lot of problem. Can anyone analyze the second example for me? Someone analyze the second example for me. It has a lot of problem in terms of the minor premise as well as conclusion. Ngọc Thảo, go ahead.
I think that here they write that animals contribute to the ecosystem and Woody is a dog, but no evidence has been proved that Woody is an animal or a dog is an animal to have like the connection. So that it leads to the conclusion that Woody is also a part of the ecosystem. It missed the link here. That is Woody or maybe a dog is an animal as well.
Okay, Ngọc Thảo recognized one problem. Ngọc Thảo phát hiện là vấn đề đầu tiên đó. General statements, cái general là deductive, là diễn dịch, bao giờ nó cũng bắt đầu từ một cái general. Và cái general đó nó phải đúng. Đúng không? Thì những cái sau nó mới đúng.
the general là gì? Animals contribute to the ecosystem. We accept that. But the minor premise, so the general statements had two elements. The subject, animals. What do animals do? They contribute to the ecosystem, okay? But the minor premise, Goody is a dog. There is no connections between minor premise and the major one. The major mentions about animals. But the second minor, Goody is a dog. There is not connections with the major one, okay? Not the elements of animals, not the element of contribute to the ecosystem. No. So therefore, we couldn't see the connections here. Cho nên khi các em làm ví dụ, các em thấy là cái minor premise must logically connect with the general one in order to establish a sound, a valid example. Okay, the next one. What is a problem with the conclusion two? Ngọc Thảo mới phát hiện một vấn đề thôi. There is another problem with the conclusion. A big problem. The author of this example, can you recognize your mistake?
Yeah, can I fix my problem?
Yes, please tell me.
Animals contribute to the ecosystem. Goody is an animal, and Goody contribute to the ecosystem.
Right. Goody contributes to the ecosystem must be the conclusion. Here you say Goody is a part of the ecosystem. Your conclusion is not matched with the general statements. The general statement is the truth. And you jump out to another conclusion not connected completely with the truth. So we wonder whether your conclusion is true or not. You didn't prove your conclusion at all because contribute to the ecosystem is different from a part of the ecosystem, right? It's not coincide, it's not overlaps, it's not exactly the same in meaning. And therefore, it's come to my mind a wonder questions. Well, is there any consistency or the same of contribute to the ecosystem and a part of the ecosystem, okay? So therefore, please be very careful. But however, you correctly revise your example. That's good, you understand the point. The next one, is there any problem or it's good? The next one, Thu Thủy. Thu Thủy, are you there? Someone mentioned that you have a problem with the in-house issues and therefore you have to leave the laptop for a while, then turn back. Have you turned back? Châu Long, what about your idea of this example? Is it a good one?
Yeah, I don't see any problems in this example.
This is a very good example, right? The next one, all Vietnamese eat rice in their meals. I am a Vietnamese, therefore I eat rice in my meals. What is the problem here? Not the structure way, but the meaning. Can you see any problems with this argument? Ngọc Yến? Have any idea?
Yes, miss.
What do you think of this example? There are some problems. Can you see it?
Sorry, Miss, I have not found out the problem.
Okay, Phu. Could you see the problem, Huynh-Nga? Okay, Huynh-Nga, go.
Well, I think that the major premise is not the fact.
It's not true. It's not right? True. Not always true.
Yes.
Okay, right. Good, Huynh-Nga. Regarding the structure, okay? This is a very good structure of deductive arguments. There is no complaining about your structuring the way you argue. It's good. You follow exactly the structure. But you know that the structure is only appearance. It couldn't give you a very sound argument if each of the premises is unsound. Sound and unsound, valid and invalid. In order to come to a good argument, each of the premises have to be true, have to be sound, have to be effective, have to be valid. And you look at this example. All Vietnamese people eat rice in their meals. This one is not true all the time. The major premise is not valid all the time. Because the major premise is not valid, so therefore your argument is not valid and your conclusion is not truthful. Okay? So you see, the structuring is one of the issues of having a sound argument. The truth, the evidences to prove your premise. Major premise have to be proved to be true. Okay? The minor premise have to be true, and therefore you have a good, the true conclusion. But the major premise has a problem. It is not true. Therefore, the whole arguments are weak and destroyed. Okay, it's not accepted, unsound. Okay, we come to the next one. A grizzly is a bear. A bear is a mammal. A grizzly is a mammal. What is the problem here? What is the problem here? Is it deductive? Or is it an inductive? A grizzly is a bear. A bear is a mammal. Is that a general? Which one is a general statement and which one is a particular statement? Các em nhìn thấy cái problems of this example, can you? A grizzly is a bear. A bear is a mammal. A grizzly is a mammal. Can you see a problem with this argument? A lot of problems. Oh.
Yes. I think that a bear is a mammal is a general premise. A grizzly bear is a detail. It's more detail. So this can be fixed. And a bear is a mammal. A grizzly bear is a grizzly is a bear. And the conclusion is a grizzly is a mammal.
Okay. Well. Yeah, I see an issues you raise. A grizzly is a particular, right? You yes. Look at the conclusion here. You would like to prove a grizzly is a mammal. This is a particular. Tại vì cái cấu trúc mà gọi là deductive của chúng ta
miễn dịch của chúng ta là lúc nào nó cũng phải bắt đầu từ một cái tổng thể general, một cái chung, và nó come to particular hoặc là nó come to general và nó đi đến một cái kết luận chung khác hoặc là nó đi đến một cái kết luận cụ thể. Thì chúng ta thấy từ cái chung tới cái chung nó quá chung cho nên ta không sử dụng trong luật. Ok, bây giờ chúng ta chỉ còn một cái mà chúng ta sử dụng được trong luật thôi, là từ một nhận định chung đúng đắn đưa vào một tình huống cụ thể nó khớp các cái điều kiện thì chúng ta đưa đến kết luận. Thì cái kết luận, cái mệnh đề mà các em đang muốn chứng minh là đây: a grizzly bear is bear, bear, right? Not bear. Bear is a mammal. That is the conclusion that you could like to prove. So you have to start with a general. Như vậy thì các em phải bắt đầu từ general chứ. Sao các em lại bắt đầu từ particular? A grizzly is a particular that you want to prove. And you start with a particular. Then you come to the conclusion and then you come back to a particular. This is something illogic in structuring. Đây là một cái lỗi trong cấu trúc. Được chưa em? Can you see your mistake? The author of this example, who is it?
Yes, miss. It's okay. Me.
Okay, Ian. Yeah. Và kể cả cái general statements here. Các em không có dùng một cái general statement mà các em dùng là a bear, bear chứ đúng không? Con gấu nó phải bear chứ đâu phải bear. A bear. Thì cái cấu trúc, cái general statement của các em này nè cũng sai luôn. Các em phải bắt đầu từ một cái chung. All bears is are a mammal, or every bear is a mammal. Every là each and all, đúng không? Cái từ every trong tiếng Anh nó là each and all. Thì các em dùng là every bear is a mammal. Thì các em đưa nó trở về chung, đúng không? Mỗi con gấu, tất cả các con gấu và mỗi con gấu thì đều là mammal. Sau đó thì các em mới vào con a grizzly is a bear. Therefore, a grizzly is a mammal. Thì các em phải cấu trúc như vậy nó mới đúng được và nó mới thuyết phục được.
Yes, I got it.
Okay. Next one. Next one. Is it a good example? All students have to wear uniform. Ling is a student, therefore she must wear uniform. Is it good? Example, Thu Thủy. Thu Thủy. Again, Thu Thủy has not focused on studying at all. Okay. Thu Thủy, can you speak up? You haven't been out for a while. Some of your friends have to give chat to me explaining that you are not focused and now you turn back. Could you prove me that you are now here focusing on your...
Sorry, Miss Anne. I think about Thảo Vy is not totally...
Thanh Nhàn talk about Thảo Vy, right? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. What about Thu Thủy? Is there any problem with Thu Thủy because she turned on her microphone and we couldn't see anything and then she turned it off? So name of mine. We have to, I have minus for Thu Thủy here. Ngọc Vy as well. Okay, so I would like to ask Hoàng Yến. What do you think of this example, Hoàng Yến?
Yes, I think the sentence have a good structure.
Yeah.
And if the meaning of the major premise is true and this is a sound argument, is it?
I think the sentence that our student have to wear uniform is not a fact.
Okay. You have to limit more. For example, all the students of the police school have to wear uniform. It's more sound, right? It's more effective. All students of our university is have not to wear a uniform. And therefore, it's not true for our university, but it's true for the police academy, right? So therefore, you have to limit much more in terms of the major premise in order to be proved to be true, okay, in order to have good argument. But this is in general, okay. The next one. All humans are mortal, ethical. Bush is a human. Therefore, Bush is mortal. What do you mean by mortal? Có đạo đức đó, đúng không? Who is the author of this example? Can you explain your ideas?
Mortal means die. I mean the death. Hello?
Tất cả mọi người thì chết đó hả em?
Dạ đúng rồi cô.
Vậy thì cái lỗi thể hiện rồi. Is it true to present like this?
Okay. Sorry.
Okay. Cái lỗi ở đây là cái lỗi thể diễn đạt. Đúng không các em? Nếu mà chính tiếng Anh mà các em diễn đạt all humans are mortal. Cô không có hiểu á. Mấy đứa có hiểu không dạ? Cô không có chuyên ngôn ngữ đâu nhưng mà cô không có hiểu. Các bạn khác hiểu không? Cô nghĩ là cái lỗi diễn đạt. Đúng không? Mọi người cuối cùng bao giờ cũng phải đi đến cái chết chẳng hạn. Thì cái cách diễn đạt của các em là nó không có được clear. Câu này khó hiểu thôi. Chứ còn nếu mà nói về cấu trúc, structure is okay. But the first major, maybe you are correct in your meaning, but the way you present in English. Không bất tử á. Thảo Nhi nói là không bất tử. Đằng này ý của bạn tác giả nói rằng là mọi người đều phải chết. Không bất tử với đều phải chết nó có giống nhau không vậy? Bất tử là một cái khái niệm nó mang cái tính chất là mental hay là physical body, okay? So there are some arguments regarding your major premise. The major premise is arguable. It's not true all the time or it's not clear in the meaning and therefore it comes to the arguments of your truth, the your statement, whether it's true or not. Okay, so it's just explaining how to use deductive arguments in terms of general to particular. Here, syllogism begins with general, ends with particular. You know how to use it. That is the most important point that I would like to mention. Now we come to the second type of argument. It is inductive arguments. Inductive always starts with a particular proposition and it can end with either a general one or it can end with particular propositions. So therefore, inductive reasoning have two ways, two subcategories. Reasoning by generalization and reasoning by analogy. Reasoning by generalizations. I can give you an example here. You know Pavlovian experiments. Em biết thí nghiệm của Pavlov không? Học sinh học rồi đó. Pavlovian conditioning causes dog Fido to salivate when a bell rings. Ông Pavlov, ông cho con chó ăn, mỗi lần cho ăn là ông cho cái chuông nó reng thì cho nó ăn, đúng không? Pavlovian conditioning causes dog Luva to salivate when a bell rings. And many tested, many experiments also come to the same conclusion. Pavlovian conditioning causes dog Spot to salivate when a bell rings, and Pavlovian conditioning causes dog Donkey to salivate when a bell rings. After many experiments, Pavlov come to the conclusion that Pavlovian conditioning causes all dogs to salivate when a bell rings. So you see, this is kind of inductive argument. Particular, it start with particular. It start with particular for dog Fido, particular case for dog Rover, particular case for dog Sport, Donkey, and other dogs, particular cases. And because it's proved to be true for many cases, for a lot of cases, and then it comes to the conclusion in general to maximize that and come to the conclusion all dogs to salivate when a bell rings. Is this example true and to be used in legal context? Cái loại chứng minh này có được sử dụng trong lĩnh vực luật không? Is this type of arguments used in legal context? In legal arguments? Có được dùng không vậy các em? Có được dùng không? Theo kiến thức hiểu biết của các em, cái loại này có được dùng trong luật không vậy? Hiểu sang, what do you think? Your opinion, Tiểu Sang.
Actually, I'm not excellent at law subjects, so.
I think
maybe in some cases they would apply this method to like prove the truth.
Right. Okay, this method of argument is popular use in natural science. For example, in order to introduce or to manufacture the vaccine, for example, the Pfizer or Sputnik V or Moderna, right? Nanocovax, in order to produce a good vaccine for people to use to fight against pandemic. You see that they have to do a lot of tests. Previously, they test within the laboratory. And then they practice or test or did an experiment on human being. And they have three rounds of testing. The first test was volunteer for about 1,000 persons. The second round is for one about 5,000 persons, 5,000 cases. The third round have to be proved on 30,000, 50,000 cases in order to come to the conclusion. For example, the process of manufacturing the new vaccine. You see that? So therefore, inductive is popularly used in natural science, medicine, physical, biological, a lot of areas. And the truth here, the conclusion here is very much depending on how many tests, how many experiments that people have tested, okay, in order to come to the truth. Trong lĩnh vực khoa học tự nhiên thì cái loại inductive argument này dùng rất là nhiều. Nhưng các em lưu ý là từ những cái case cụ thể mà đến được một cái kết luận chung tổng quát này, nó muốn đúng thì cái số lượng các cái test rất là quan trọng. Bao nhiêu test thì nó mang cái tính chất đầy đủ để chúng ta đánh giá được cái kết luận cuối cùng. Cho nên là các em thấy ví dụ như cô nói vừa rồi, cô nói ví dụ về sản xuất vaccine á, là nó phải test rất nhiều, test vòng 1.000 người, test vòng 2-3.000 người, test vòng 3 cả 30.000 người, 50.000 người trên một đất nước hoặc trên một tỉnh, thành phố hoặc nhiều cái đối tượng test là những loại người khác nhau nữa cơ, để đưa đến một cái kết luận chung là all dogs hoặc là all human beings who are vaccinated to be able to fight against COVID-19 better than without vaccination. Okay, so that in order to come to such a conclusion, there is a lot of evidences have to be proved, particular cases have to be proved in order to come to the general conclusion. My question is that whether it is used in our legal field? The answer is yes. Okay, you see that many precedents, case law is the term to express this one. And this is very popular in the common law system. Nguyên tắc này, cái cách này nó cũng dùng trong lĩnh vực luật học các em. Và đặc biệt nó dùng ở trong hệ thống thông luật á. Các em thấy họ có cái từ là case law. Law comes from the case. Thẩm phán có quyền làm luật đó các em, là từ cái tình huống trong thực tiễn cuộc sống. Thì người ta dựa trên nguyên tắc chung, người ta sẽ đưa ra cái phán quyết. Cái phán quyết đó nó trở thành binding. Nếu mà phán quyết của tòa cấp cao á, tòa mà có giá trị á, thì nó sẽ binding over the lower courts. Nó trở thành một cái general rules, đúng không? Trong hệ thống thông luật thì khi có một tình huống mới xảy ra trong cuộc sống, như thế nào? Thì những cái new cases như vậy thì người ta phải deal với, và khi người ta deal với những cái cases như vậy thì người ta đến cùng một cái kết luận, và những cái kết luận đó nó trở thành những nguyên tắc chung của luật, nó trở thành một cái general rules. Và như vậy cách này rất phổ biến trong hệ thống thông luật. Cái hệ thống vừa rồi các em, từ một nguyên tắc chung nó dẫn đến tình huống cụ thể thì nó rất phổ biến trong hệ thống civil law, là hệ thống dân luật của chúng ta. Cái general rule bao giờ nó cũng in written form. It is legislative. It is written in the codes, criminal codes, constitution, civil codes, etc. Those codes have written rules. That is the truth. That is the requirements. That is the fixed problems. Yeah, that is the conclusions already. So it is accepted as a truth. And then we apply that general rule into particular case of our clients. So that is a deductive way, general to particular. It's very popular in the civil law system, like Vietnam. But this is quite more popular in the common law system. Okay? Judges make rules. From particular cases, they develop general rule. Another way of deductive is reasoning by analogy. It also starts with a particular proposition, but it ends not with a general. It ends with causes Dockfeder's sounding weight when a bell rings. This is a particular case. And then it comes to another particular case. That is the case of Cat Felix. So in order to come to the conclusion that Pavlovian conditioning causes Cat Felix to salivate when a bell rings, you have to prove the similarities between Cat Felix and the dog Fido, so that the same results will happen to cat felix when the same test or experiment have been made, conducted. And therefore, in the premise two, it says cat felix resembles, yeah, having similarities to dog fido by similarity in factor A, similarity B, similarity C. These similarities are decisive in coming to the conclusion that Pavlovian conditioning causes cat felix also to salivate when a bell rings. So you see, this is a kind of difficult way of arguing things. This is very difficult one. You have to find out the similarities, and you have to prove these similarities are key elements to give the requirements, conditions for the test to be true. Okay, so it's very difficult way, difficult to prove this. What about legal context? Now, appellate case one holds that a contract concluded by unauthorized person was void. Case one. What about case two? A similar conclusion comes. Appellate case two held that a contract concluded by unauthorized person was void. Appellate case three also held that a contract concluded by unauthorized person was void. So from particular cases, come to the same conclusion. So therefore, we have a general rule that all contracts concluded by unauthorized person are void. So you see, this is inductive argument, inductive reasoning. You come to prove this statement, the last one, the conclusion is the thing that you want to prove. And this one is general, all contracts with unauthorized persons, right? So therefore, you have to start with a particular case. Particular to general, inductive by syllogism. Đây chính là sự quy nạp mà bằng phương pháp tổng hợp, đúng không? Từng cái nhỏ, người ta tổng hợp nên cái kết luận chung to hơn. Okay, so now that is the first part of arguments. We just view the general ways of proving things in our general life and accept it. Now we focus particular on legal arguments. What about legal arguments? What types of arguments can we use in order to prove things or to disprove things? We have inductive generalization. We also use inductive analogy. And we also use deductions, okay? But deductions, we only limit, okay, first of all, look at deductive argument, deductions here. We only limit the use to the structuring from general to particular. We don't use general to general in legal context. General to particular, this is called categorical syllogism. And this is often used as legal principles to a particular case. This is very popular in Vietnam, because legal principles are often in our written code, written legislations. Look at deductive arguments. It starts with particular, okay, right here. Too general, okay. This creates, okay, a case legal principle. Okay, from cases, we create a legal principle, okay? So therefore it's called create appellate case legal principles. Why appellate? Because the first hearing is often to be kind of appealed, and the appellate one is the final decision. As I already mentioned, it's popular in common law system. The second subcategory of deductive arguments is particular to particular. It is analogy. That you have to select a legal principle, a precedent, the case law, in order to apply into your particular case. Okay. So now, if you get this overview, I will come to a particular example. What time is finished? 10:20, isn't it? That is the finishing time of our class today, is it? 10:20? Chúng ta đã học tới 10:20, đúng không?
Dạ, đúng rồi.
Okay, so now, I try to give you an example. Okay, inductive, particular to general. Here. Appellate case one held that a contract with Victor was void. The second appellate case held that a contract with a Victor was void. Appellate case three had the same conclusion, and therefore it established the general principle. All contracts with vague terms are void. Okay, it's easy. But you have to note it that the concept all contracts with vague terms are void will never be the same over time, will never be the justice over centuries, right? Will never be unchanged. That is the idea. Okay? This conclusion or every law, even written legislations, remains subject to exceptions and modifications. Because the facts, the circumstances, the context, the mind of human beings have changed. Their perspectives have changed. For example, previously, most or almost all of the criminals are imprisoned or convicted to be put into the prison, into the jail. But nowadays, when human beings' mind has changed and they have the more of humanitary, human kind of human rights approach. So not all of the criminals are convicted to be in prison, but they make divert. Some of them are only warned. Some of them are only fined with a certain amount of money. Some of them even have to be diverted out of the justice system, the imprisonment system, right? To make only an excuses or deal with the victims and get the negotiations or bargains and then stop there. And therefore you see that the human perspective have been changed. The factual circumstances have been changed. Previously, we haven't got the internet, and there is no kind of harmful conduct regarding the internet security. But nowadays, hacking and a lot of very dangerous conducts within the using of internet, and therefore the perspective on the human behavior using the internet have been changed. And there are some modifications in terms of the rules of how to use the this kind of humans events, right? Humans kind of creations. And therefore, every rules are subject to exceptions and modifications. Even the case law, and especially case law, because case law is easily changed due to the revisions or the changing in the facts. And therefore, you see, this rule, all contracts with victims subjected to modifications, and it will be changed whenever a new appellate case appears. The higher courts, new facts, right? Minor changes to these rules, okay? And even the case law may be changed by the legislations as well. The National Assembly, the House, okay, of Commons or the House of Lords, the Parliament, can issue or enact the statute or constitutions in order to amend case law, okay? And therefore, maybe some contracts with vague term are enforceable. Em hiểu vấn đề này chưa? Do you understand this point? Yes or no? Em hiểu điều nãy giờ cô nói chưa? Luật pháp không bao giờ bất định, đúng không? Không bao giờ bất biến hết, mà nó sẽ có thay đổi theo thời gian. Nó sẽ bị thay đổi khi cái quan điểm của con người thay đổi, khi những cái tình huống, bối cảnh thực tiễn của đời sống xã hội nó thay đổi, thì luật pháp nó thay đổi. Còn các em, ngay cả trong khoa học tự nhiên cũng thế thôi. Có những điều trước đây tưởng chừng như là chân lý, nhưng sau đó có một cái sự khám phá mới của con người, thì nó sẽ thay đổi cái quan điểm. Cô lấy ví dụ như trong khoa học tự nhiên á, trước đây thì chúng ta tưởng rằng là trong cái cấu tạo của nguyên tử thì các em sẽ thấy nó có atom, đúng không? Là hạt nhân á, thì nó sẽ có neutron và proton là những cái hạt đó. Nhưng mà sau dưới cái hạt đó, bây giờ người ta tưởng những cái hạt đó là hạt nhỏ nhất. Nhưng mà khoa học vật lý đã phát triển đến cái mức là có những cái hạt nhỏ hơn. Và trước đây chúng ta tưởng cái power của atom, là năng lượng hạt nhân, là cái năng lượng superpower. Nhưng vừa rồi cô mới xem một cái YouTube mới về cái sự phát minh khoa học, là nó còn có cái gọi là cái năng lượng coi như là cái power thứ tư á, cái dưới cái power của atom nữa, atomic power nữa, nó còn tìm được một cái power mới còn mạnh hơn nữa. Như vậy thì cái kiến thức và hiểu biết của loài người nó không bao giờ limit cả. Chúng ta dừng tới mức độ nào đó là do cái giới hạn về khả năng nhận thức của chúng ta thôi. Chứ nó còn sâu hơn nữa. Ngày xưa thì y học phát triển là chúng ta nhìn thấy con vi khuẩn thôi. Bây giờ còn nhìn thấy con virus là nhỏ nhỏ gấp bao nhiêu lần so với cái con vi khuẩn nữa. Đúng không nào? Nó rất nhỏ. Cái khẩu trang các em đeo thì nó giống như là cái hàng rào mà kẽm gai thôi, mà con virus nó vẫn chui qua được vậy. Cho nên có những cái khẩu trang là người ta càng phải cho những cái chất để diệt nó vào. Có nghĩa là nó gần tới đó nó đã bị diệt, hoặc là cái thứ thì người ta phải chế tạo thêm dần lên. Thì các em sẽ thấy rằng như vậy tất cả mọi thứ, đặc biệt là kiến thức loài người, thì bao giờ cũng subject to exceptions, modification, revision. Here I plug in the power for my computer. Rồi, các em dừng tại đây trước, và lần sau cô sẽ cho các em đi vào những cái ví dụ cụ thể hơn để các em hiểu cái cách sử dụng cái nguyên lý của luật pháp trong các cái tình huống hiện nay sự vận dụng. Okay, see you tomorrow, is it, or when?
Goodbye, teacher.
When will we meet again? Thursday morning? Yeah.
Yes, Thursday.
Thursday morning. Yeah, okay, see you next time, next Thursday.